So what you see on screen here is a flowchart app that I built using AI, and I just added this feature, the ability to mute a shape. So let's say I'm actually telling a story and I don't really want the audience to get ahead of themselves. So I can use this feature to actually hide it before I get to that part of the story. Okay. So basically in this video, what I'm going to show you is actually, this is an already existing app and how I add new features to my application. And I have coded this completely in Claude, and I used a helper tool, which also I built using AI. So I'm just going to show you how do I update this code and then test it, because the point is, like, when you're updating the code, things can work, things can go wrong. Sometimes what you're adding is added, but something else goes wrong. And when something goes wrong, what to do next? So we'll cover all of that in this particular video. So how this works is basically I can click on this shape and press M and it becomes muted, or I can also right click and select unmute and mute. Okay, so this is how this feature works, and I just added that, and I'm going to actually give you a walkthrough of how I added this into this application. So this is the actual code of the application, and at this point in time, I don't have this mute feature in this code. And same code is visible here in code view it. I'm actually going to edit this code here. Okay. So this is the prompt I gave. First of all, I attached the code here. And then the prompt was, can you add a feature in the right click menu to make a shape muted? Meaning right click mute will make the outline dashed and fill color to gray. I should have an option to select the shape and right click to unmute it. And another way should be to unmute it by double clicking. So few of those initial prompt changed towards the end for the better. And that is how, when you add features, you can evolve your ideas as well. So it gave few code changes and few additional functions to add to the original code. So if you see here, it is create context menu function, which is basically the right click menu function. So I'm actually going to just copy this create context menu. I'll go to code view it, and I'm going to paste it in the search bar. And it has gone to the function create context menu. Okay. So if you see, label this thing, add this menu item. Okay. So I can just look for that particular portion and add it. Or like yesterday while I was doing this, I was feeling really lazy. So I just, you know, copied this particular context menu function, and I told Claude to basically give me the full code for that particular function. And that's what I got. So I just have to make sure that it has not added / existing code into this particular part, which is something that Claude does very often. It has not done in this case. So I'm actually going to just, so I already have it in the right place. So I'm going to copy this code from here. I'll go all the way down to figure out where the end of that function is. So it's here. And I'm going to click and drag all the way up to the selected portion. So here, and I'm going to just paste that new code. Okay. That's one thing. And another thing that was very important to actually see what is happening is the CSS function. So I had to copy this CSS function, and I'll go up here all the way up to the end of the CSS. And here I'll just click enter and paste it there towards the end, because this is just the muted shape and how the CSS styling is done here. Okay. So we should be able to see something now. So basically I'm actually going to right click. Nothing happens here. That's because the object has to be selected. So let's add a shape. Okay. I'm going to right click on this shape now. Now we have this mute menu here. Nothing's going to happen here because nothing has been activated there. So let's go back. Okay. And here, after this particular thing, the second message was the toggle mute. We need to add a new function. So I'm going to just copy. This is not an update. This basically I'm adding this one. So I will just, let's say I will just go to create context menu. Okay. I'll just copy this from here, and I just want to paste it below it. So I'm just going to copy that. And as soon as this function ends, I'm going to click enter and control V to paste it. Now this should actually make it functional. So I'm going to add a shape, right click and mute. Yes. Now the outlines are dashed and the fill is gray. Okay. So whatever I wanted to add has been added now, but you know, we need to obviously improve this whole thing. Okay. Now let's go back, and we need to see a few things here. There is this function for unmuting to double click. I had actually mentioned that I need that feature. So let's go to function edit. Okay. Function edit. Once again, I was feeling really lazy. So I just copied that and told Claude, give me the full code. So yeah, Claude gave me the full code here. And like I said, there is no slash slash existing code here. So I'm going to copy that and I will find the end of this code. From here, click and drag all the way up to that function and I'll paste it. Okay. Now let's see what happens. Okay. I just added that. And all of a sudden, you can see on screen, the cursor is basically a grab one, not the regular cursor, which means in this particular application, whenever this happens, that means there is a syntax error. Something went wrong. If there might be one colon missing or some extra bracket or one bracket missing or whatever, some syntax error. So I just went back in and told Claude that that causes a syntax error. So it gave me a new code. I'm going to copy that. Let's make sure nothing problematic is there. So I'll just copy that. And once again, I will just paste the new code. Control V. Okay. And preview. And everything is working fine. I'll just make sure that. Okay. Right click. Mute. Okay. It's working. Unmute. That is working. Okay. And okay. I will do one thing. I'll double click. That doesn't work. Okay. So anyways, let's see what more needs to be done. So here in the very first message, what else was there? Edit text. We added the CSS. And okay, this was something that Claude thought on itself. Rather than doing that double click, it gave me an option to use a shortcut, that is M, to do this. So once again, this is what it is, and we need to do that in handle keyboard shortcuts. I'm just going to copy that, go to code view it, and basically paste it and find that. But now, this is not a function, so I can see that there are two here. I will go all the way down to see where the second one is. Hopefully, I'm looking for the right thing. No, so I'm just going to see function. Okay, so I have to have it here. Okay, so that's what it is. I think I did the same thing. I actually looked for the full code. Did I do that? Yes, I did the same thing. Give me full code for function handle keyboard shortcuts. Okay. So I'll just copy that. And once again, the lazy me did this. Just click and drag it till here and control V to paste. So by adding that, now if I just select an object and add it and press M, it makes it mute. Okay, right click also works. Now, and at this point, my mind changed and I no longer wanted it to be gray like this. So I went back in and told Claude, on rethinking, I don't want the gray color for the mute, just keep the opacity adjustment. Okay, so it went in, changed just the toggle mute, which was the function that was added into the code. So I will just find that particular function here and I'm just going to replace it. Okay, so this was a much longer part of the code. Now it's shorter. Okay, so let's check what happened now. If I press M, yeah. So it maintains the color, it's no longer gray, and it has a slight opacity there. Then if I just go back to Claude, so it also gave me some kind of CSS changes. The only changes like, no, it was 0.7 or 0.8, it made it 0.4. And the reason it came back with that is because I mentioned opacity. I didn't want this. I was more or less happy with that 0.8 or 0.7 value. So I kept it as it is. Here, I realized that I also do not want to show the text. And I wanted the text to be, because that's the most important part, right? The text is basically where the story is being told. So I wanted to replace that text with a question mark. And so that's what I said. I told Claude, I want to hide the text in the shape with a question mark when muted. The question mark should read the original font size and color. Okay. So once again, it just changed the toggle mute function. I'm just going to copy that, come back here. Okay. That's correct. I will copy the entire code from there and basically replace this. Control V. Let's go back and see what else. Once again, it's just the CSS files and I don't really care to change that. So I'm just going to keep it as it is and then go and preview. Let's see what happens. Press M and we have a question mark. And let's say I change, okay, I'm just going to change the shape I will make it bold and increase the size, and let's change it to Meriwether. Okay. And then I will press M. The question mark is actually in the Meriwether. Okay. So that's good. So that is what we wanted. Let's go back. And then what I wanted to add was basically right now this is happening with the shapes, but I also wanted to add the same thing to the standalone text. Okay. So once again, Claude just gave me an update to toggle mute function. So I'll go back in, take that and paste it here. Now, this is where the problems will start, because that's the important part that you need to see. It's not when everything is working, it's great. But when things go wrong, that's when the fun actually happens. Okay. So see what happens here. I'm going to add a shape. Okay. I'm actually going to add a text. Let's say this is a text. Okay. And I'm going to click here and I'm going to press M. Nothing happens. Nothing is going to happen here. M. Okay. Nothing worked. So let's go back. And okay, there were a few other things. Okay. So because the we had this for the shapes, but we also need to add the CSS value for the standalone text. That's why it didn't work. Okay. So let's go here to the code and go all the way up to the CSS. And I will add this here. Okay. And this, now let's see if something works at all. Text. Okay. I'm going to press M. Doesn't work. Right click. Doesn't do anything. Okay. Okay, it also gave this edit text to change stuff. Basically, it is related to the standalone text itself. So I, again, lazy. So I told Claude to give me the full code for this. So I got the code and I'm going to copy that. And basically, I'll come back here and let's copy edit text function from here. Control C, Control V, find that code, copy the code, and then come find the bottom of it. And then click drag to select the whole function, paste it, and let's see what happens. Okay. This is a text. Okay. Whatever. Press M. It's not going to work because we have not yet done anything with regards to shortcut for this one. M does not work for standalone text and mute is not added to the context menu when selecting a standalone text. So it came back to us with this code. So this time I'm actually going to copy this, go in here and we will search for that. And let's see, this is where it is, const menu items. Okay, let's see. Okay, this is where it is. So I am actually going to copy all the way from here to this. So we will search for that bracket and a comma. So this is, you can see it here. See this part? Basically, yeah. Here is the comma and this one. So I'm just going to copy that portion there and paste it, replace it. Okay. So that part has been done. Now this probably should add the right click. Okay, let's see. Right click. Okay. Yeah, it added the mute button here. And you can see it does the same thing as we expected. It is mute now, but we also need to add the shortcut menu because right now that is not there. So let's go to handle keyboard shortcuts. And I'm actually going to paste that here. And let's see. Okay. This part of the code. Okay. So else if to lowercase m. Okay. I'm going to go here, this one. Okay. So what I'm going to do is basically copy this from here, this part. I'm going to copy. And because the same part is here, M, I'm going to paste it there. Control V. So what we are actually doing is, okay, it was just shape earlier. So we are adding standalone text to the code as well. So basically now if we go here and add text. Okay, and press M. Wow, it just works. Okay, but I can already see the issue here. Now here's the thing. We need to actually, okay, press M. I'm actually going to connect something. So we have a shape which M works. I'm going to connect this to this, okay? And then I will select M for this. So this is muted and this is muted. So if I just click and move this, look at what happened. Everything is disconnected. Now that's a problem, right? So once again, we have to go to Claude and say, for some reason, when the standalone text is in mute mode, the connections get disconnected. So it came back, changed a few things in the toggle mute elements. I'm just going to copy that, go here, paste it. Okay, I will just copy the code, select all of it, and paste it here. Okay, and just to be sure, I'll make sure that the code is complete. Yes, that Claude code is complete. Okay, so let's see what happens now. Okay, I am going to add a shape and a text. I will connect this to this. Okay, press M and press M. Let's try to move it and it works. Everything is fine. Okay, that's good. Okay, but now there's a new problem. You can see here in this particular shape, we can scale it. Not a problem. But I cannot do that with the text, which was important, right? Okay, so if I select this, nothing's happening. So I'm just going to try and increase the... Okay, I'm going to press M to bring that back. So now I have the handle back, so I can scale it now. If I just press M, it's gone. Okay, but now again, I cannot scale it. So I'm just going to go back and say, this is what I will say, right after using the mute, I'm not able to scale the standalone text. It works if I change the font size. Okay, again, another change to the toggle mute. And I will come back here. Just going to find that code and paste it. Let's see what that does. Okay, I am going to have a text, press M. Okay, you can see that the scale handles are actually maintained. Now I can do it. So that problem is basically solved. I just press M to bring that back and then have a shape, connect it. And let's mute this and try to move it around. And everything seems to be working fine. So this is basically how I added this new feature into my application. And it's a little bit of a flashy feature, I would feel like. I mean, I've added almost everything that is available in competitor products. So I just thought like this is something that I can add that will just give it a bit of an X factor or something like that. I really like this one. So I'm actually kind of very happy with the way it has come out. And this is how, you know, you add features into your application. Now, I have to say a few things here, which are important. That is, in this methodology, what I'm doing is I'm actually having a single vertical code. It's not modularized code. So it is easy for me to actually use something like CodeViewit to do this. Okay, let's say your code is modularized and you have multiple files and you're using that to get the code in Claude. So you will then have to use the Claude projects. So basically, if you go to anything right at the start, if you start, so you have this something called projects here. You can click on projects and you can start a project, create a project. And in each of these projects, let's call it a project. Okay, describe. I'm just going to quickly create something. Okay, so it creates this project for you. And here you have ability to add multiple files. So you can add all your files into this project knowledge area. Okay. And that's how you work with if you have multiple files and you have a modularized code. And basically the process remains the same. You start a new chat, and every time you start a new chat, you have an option to basically select a particular project that you want to work with. So that would be the process in case your code is modularized. And this is how you can add new features using AI into your existing application and at a really, really fast pace. I hope this video helped you in some way or the other. If you would like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.